Hi, welcome to our video on diabetic medications. Let's get started with a question. So after we read the question, I'm going to want you to pause the video and write your answer before you look at the rest of the presentation. Ready? Okay, which type of diabetic patient cannot receive most of the oral anti-diabetic medications and why? The answer is type 1 diabetic patients. They don't benefit from most of the anti-diabetic medications because the beta cells of their pancreas have been destroyed. The mechanism of action of most of these oral anti-diabetic medications is to stimulate insulin release from the pancreas. Well, remember, if you're a type 1 patient, your pancreas is dead. Not just mostly dead, as they say, it's dead. So the damaged pancreas of a type 1 patient is not able to accommodate these oral medications. Now, when we're addressing anti-diabetic medications, we're looking at drugs that are against diabetes, so they're going to help us lower blood sugar. There's two major groups. Oral drugs, which I love the graphic that they put here for you, and non-insulin injectable drugs. These are drugs that we use to treat diabetes, but they can't be swallowed. They have to be injected, and they're not insulin. Most of the drugs that we'll discuss fall into the oral category, but there's a couple we'll talk about in the injectable category. Now, there are 7 families of oral anti-diabetic medications that we're going to go over. So these drugs are taken by mouth. There's the biguanides, the second-generation sulfonylureas, the meglitinides, we call those the glinides, the thiazinolides, we just call them glitazones, the alpha-glucosidase inhibitors, the DPP-4 inhibitors, and the dopamine agonists. So, now here's a study tip. Mark this slide in your notes and your presentation. Because it has 7 of the major classes and categories of oral medications that we use for type 2 diabetics, I want you to use this as a reference. Go back to this slide to quiz yourself. That's the most effective way to check your learning. Just randomly pick a number, put your finger on it, or have somebody in your family pick a number between 1 and 7, and then go down the list of things that you know about each drug, as they call it. So ask your roommate to pick a number. If they pick number 3, then share what you know about the glinides, why we use them, and what some of the adverse effects are. The more you quiz yourself over and over, that spaced repetition will help you recall and retain that information. Now, there's one more group. They're the sodium glucose cotransporter 2s, which was why we call them the SGLT-2 inhibitors. This is another group of oral anti-diabetic medications, but this is what's really cool about this. We can use it with type 2 diabetics, but it also may be helpful for type 1. This is news. They're doing clinical studies now, but it's really a cool development for type 1 diabetics. Now, it does not replace insulin, but it may help them be more effective with their insulin. So stay tuned. We'll see what the research shows. But this one group, sodium glucose cotransporter 2s, might have some really incredible clinical applications for type 1 diabetics. And it is the only one of the oral medications that right now looking promising to deal with type 1 diabetics.